Yes, sir. Yes, sir. This is week two. Me and Sean. What's up? It's your boy Big Med inside the mind of Med. Again, this is week two. I got my girl Sean Chase sitting across from me. How you doing, Sean?
I'm tired.
Okay.
Excuse my yawn. I may sound a little, you know, raspy at the voice. I'm tired, but I'm ready.
You ready?
Yes.
How was your week?
Week was good. Busy. Getting acquainted into some new stuff. So it's been busy.
I heard spaghetti night tonight.
Spaghetti night tonight.
Spaghetti night.
Spaghetti night tonight. You gotta cook for the honey. You know, it's like 1 degree outside. We can't do dinner like we always do outside.
So
We'll eat in tonight.
Right. Now, interesting thing I heard you say. You're cutting your stove on for the first time tonight.
Yeah.
Is it because it's a brand new stove?
Actually, yes. I moved a month ago. And I don't cook. I don't cook. I'm in a grocery shop. You know, my refrigerator consists of juice. Ice cream.
Right.
Water.
Okay.
That's about it.
Really?
Yeah. You know, so it's real pick up and go around my house. But I mean, it's just me.
Cook.
Nah, I don't cook.
You didn't accidentally pick up a pointer from your mother or nothing like that?
You know, my mom was a businesswoman.
So she didn't cook either?
Nah.
Didn't cook either.
It's like one of those generational non-cooking things.
Oh. So what did your dad eat?
You know what?
Did your dad cook?
Story. No. Oh. Dad wasn't. I was raised by my mom and my grandmother.
Gotcha.
So grandma threw down.
Okay.
Yeah, grandma threw down.
It didn't skip a generation. It just went away, huh?
Yeah. I mean, I can cook. Like, I mean, it's one of those things, like, you know, I'm
you know real. How to boil, you know how to boil noodles?
You know, I actually put my noodles in the microwave.
Stop.
Yeah. Okay. Like ramen noodles? Like noodles. I mean, I'm making spaghetti, so of course I can cook.
It's spaghetti.
I'm boiling. I mean, of course I can boil noodles.
That's good.
You know, I can make rice. Some people can make rice.
It took me a while. It took me a while to figure out rice. Yeah. I can make a lasagna, though.
I can make a lasagna, too.
Really?
Mm-hmm. But I use turkey meat.
Me, too.
Yeah. I don't ground beef. Like the smell of it kind of.
I just don't do beef or pork.
Yeah. Oh.
Really? Yeah, you know. Yeah, it's, you know.
You dead outside your race?
Do I dead outside my race?
Yeah.
I guess. I'm not Muslim if you're trying to.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm not.
Mean, I'm just wondering.
Nah, you know, I'm more of a, if I'm dating outside my race, there's probably going to be another minority.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're going to share that.
Oh, okay.
That much, you know, Caucasian females are interesting. They intrigue me.
Mm.
But,
really?
They're intriguing.
How so?
Because I see them all the time because, my roommate dates white girls. So.
Does he eat pork?
Wait, what kind of pork are you talking about?
I mean, like, you know, white meat is white meat.
I'm confused now. Wait. are we talking about pork or are we talking about pork?
No. I mean, okay, so never mind. Your roommate dates outside of his race and he dates white girls. And
yeah.
Pretty ones, though, are like, you know, those average ones, like with that SpongeBob booty. Like, you know.
He don't do that. I think actually I'm not gonna say that they're not ugly. I'm not gonna say that. Can't say that. He wouldn't do that. But like for me, like I said, like certain white girls just don't attract me, you know? And the ones that he likes just don't attract me. But I've seen him date some ones that were bad in my perspective. So, you know.
Like bad, like not good.
No, bad as great.
Oh.
Great, so, you know, my roommate, you know, you'll meet him. He'll be probably on here with us one of these days.
Does he have manti teo, like preferences, or like how does he?
Well, see, manti teo type preferences are invisible and non-existing.
Like,
and we're gonna get into that in a second. We're gonna get into that one in a second. You know, because you try to come at me with the dating outside my. Would you date outside your race?
Mm-hmm.
You date a white man?
Would I? If he looked like David Beckham, absolutely.
I've always wondered that because when it comes to black women and dating white men, there has to be a certain look to them.
Yeah. He has to be dope. Like, he just has to, he can't be like.
Just a regular white guy.
Nah, he can't be like the American Pie type of white guys. He has to be like...
He has to have an accent.
You know, no.
No?
Not necessarily. He can be like the ones that were in like Ocean's...
Like Brad Pitt.
Yes, like Brad Pitt, like Mark Wahlberg, like...
Rugged.
He has to look good.
Have to have like that kind of... that. I hate the word swag about him.
He has... I mean, he just has to be like...
Understood.
Nice.
I understand. And the funny thing about me is, as a man, because I know when you see black men dating white women, you really don't turn your head. But to me, even now, after all this, if I see a white man with a black woman, I'm still looking at him like...
Why?
I'm like, wow.
Why?
It's just... Because it's you rarely see a black woman with a white guy. I've seen black girls go out on a date with a white guy and say, I can't do this. You know what I'm saying? It's just, I can't do this.
Yeah, he can be, you know, he can be strange.
And what
he
I've also
corny.
And what I've also heard is that when black girls do go out with white guys, it's just a different approach that these white guys have with them that kind of throws them off. Mm-hmm. As in, from what I heard, they treat them nice.
Yeah.
The conversation doesn't go straight to sex. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They don't feel that pressure of sex, like all of them on like the first date. They feel like they've been respected throughout.
Yeah.
I heard that from some girl. And I'm like, damn, really? Is it that bad? She's like, it's that bad.
That thirst dating is real.
It is.
It is. I mean, it's funny because like men like to reference, you know, women being thirsty and things like that. Mm-hmm. But with men, I mean, it's
bad.
Like, you know, I was single for a while.
Mm-hmm.
Before I got into a relationship. And, you know, once a man meets you and he learns that you live by yourself, it's like, somebody going to cook me dinner. Like, someone, can I come over and hang out? And it's like, why, you know, why do you feel the need to...
Ooh, this is about to spark something else. We're about to get into this in a second. We're going to Miguel. This is a new song, Do You?
Do You.
I haven't even heard this one yet.
I like it.
Okay, we're about to play it right now then. And we're going to get back into this whole dating thing. This is... Oh, yeah, okay.
Okay.
Completely going off script right now.
I
don't care. I like where this is going. Let's do this. Whenever it feels like playing.